This conference will now be recorded.
So, what we, a small recap what we discussed. You can able to see my screen, right? Can you able to see my screen?
Yeah, your screen is visible.
Oh. Okay, it's more discussion what happened yesterday. So we have discussed about in the previous classes, like we had discussed about the static and non-static, and there is a small recap also done on that. And we have discussed mainly yesterday about the constructors and what is the purpose of your constructor and what are the types of constructors you have. So generally, when I'll be using a constructor, whenever you create an object, the constructor code is the first statement that is going to be executed, and why you use the constructor. So whenever you want to initialize the value, so whenever you want the instance variables or some instance variables or some part of the code to be executed at the time of object creation, so you want to give some value to an instance variable, right? So by default, if you are not giving any value to an instance variable at the time of object creation, as I told you, whenever the object is creating, it is going to create all their instance members memory, right? So whenever the instance variable value is creating, it will be created with the zero default value whenever the object is creating. But when you want that, we do not want that zero value to be initiated, and you want some instance like you want some value, like for an ID you want some two or some value you want to be done at the time of creating an object, then you do declare that inside a constructor. It is not only for the variables, it is you can be writing any kind of code inside the constructor that can be executed only once. And there are two types of constructors that we have, that is zero parameter and zero parameter, or you can call it as default, or one more is a parameterized constructor. By default, every class will have a zero parameterized constructor. So who is going to write the constructor for you? The compiler is going to write the constructor if we are not writing any constructor in our class. But if in case if you are trying to write any constructor in your class, your compiler is not going to write the constructor for you. And the compiler will not write one parameter or two parameters. It is going to write only the zero parameterized constructor. And when I use one parameter, when I use zero parameter. So when you want all the instance variable values to be same, you can go for zero parameterized constructor. But when you want that instance variables value to be different for all the objects, then you go for parameterized constructor. And we have seen an example with a student, and a constructor example also we have covered. So hope no queries, right? So we need to discuss today, and what we have seen at this keyword. So when you use this keyword, anyone can tell me?
Which keyword?
This keyword, this dot we used, right? So when will you use this keyword?
Yeah, so that means we are referring to the local object.
So what is the scenario that we'll use this keyword?
Yeah, so there was like in class you have defined some value, you have defined some variables, and then in the constructor you again we have defined some variables with the same name, right? So just to point out which variable to use, we are using this.
Yes, exactly, very good. So like it's like whenever your local variable name and instance variable names are same, to make the differentiation you use this keyword. So here we have seen this example, this dot id equals to id, this dot name equals to name. right? And you understood what is the usage of the constructor itself. So what happened when you have a constructor, one parameterized constructor, at the time of creating an object itself, you are passing the values. So I asked you to do some, like someone asked me to do some assignment, like have you done that? Is any you have done?
I was doing some, I was doing some like the one which you have told us in previous class, but not this one.
Okay, I have asked you yesterday like to do a calculator.
Yeah,
and
calculator and all. Yeah.
Right?
I will be doing maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
So I was just revising the previous classes and all. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyone done? Yesterday I have given the assignment like to do something. Someone from you suggested that it could be better that some assignment has to be given. So the person who suggested
it's
have
like,
done that.
It seems like not, that participant did not join today. Yes, she did not join, seems like.
I was expecting yesterday that today I should ask her. And I think she has not done, and she has not joined, maybe. Not sure.
Yeah. Yes.
It's like everything is work. So what it is like, even this is a free course, but we could be, we'll make it little serious and we could be learning, right? So that's the reason I just even.
Yeah.
Okay, please try to do that calculator, and if possible, I'll try at the end of the session. I'll try to give something today also. Please try to complete.
Yes, sure.
Okay. So we have this with dot. Similarly, you have this with brackets. So what is the purpose of this with brackets is nothing but this, it always indicates it will state about your it is going to say that the current object. So why we use this with brackets also here? So what is the purpose of this with brackets is nothing but, so assume that in this class I am having one more constructor. Okay, let me take this constructor example. Otherwise, so here how many constructors I have? I have one parameterized constructor, right? So similarly, what I do, I'll be creating zero parameterized constructor. So when I do zero parameterized constructor, obviously it will throw me an error because your compiler has written, so you have written one parameter, so your compiler will not write zero. So it is your responsibility to write the zero parameterized constructor, right? So I am returning the zero parameterized constructor. Inside zero parameter constructor. Okay, so here I can tell that instead of passing the values, here I'll not print this. It's like I'll just say that this is like my one parameterized constructor. So if you want to call this one parameterized constructor, how you need to create an object, you need to create with one parameter. When you want to call zero parameter, you need to create with zero parameter. Assume that you have similarly two parameterized constructor. So then you will be passing the two parameters here, right? Int I, comma string name. So I'm just writing here inside two parameterized constructor. So if you want to again call this two parameter, you need to create two parameter constructor, object with two parameter, right? But I do not want to do that. So it's like to execute the constructor, what I have to do here, I need to create an object with that two parameter, right? So that will call the two parameterized constructor, right? So this is the general scenario. So now if you execute, what happens? All the constructors will be executed, right? One, zero, two, because you are calling in that order only. But what I want is nothing, but I do not want this. So I'll be creating an object with only one parameterized constructor or zero parameterized constructor. From that constructor, if I want to execute the other constructor, you are getting my question, right? I will create only this one parameterized constructor, right? So if I run this code, which one will execute? Only one parameter execute. This zero parameter constructor and the two parameter will not execute because you have not created the object of with that, right? Only one parameter execute. But what I want from one parameter, I want to execute the other constructor. Then what I have to do? I need to use this with brackets. So from one constructor, if you want to call another constructor, then what to use? We be using this with brackets. So for example, from this constructor exe, I just want to call two parameterized constructor. Then what I'll use? I'll be using two, I'll pass this two parameters here. Like, and your this keyword should be the first statement. So now it will call this two parameterized constructor. From this two parameterized constructor, if you want to call zero parameterized constructor, then what I'll do? I'll be using this same. So then it will call your zero parameterized constructor. So now how many construct, how many object I created? I created only one object with one parameterized constructor, but I'll be executing all the three constructors. So by using which keyword? By using this keyword. So can someone tell me what will be the output? It will be 1, 2, 3 or 0, 2, 3. Can you tell me? Someone tell me what would be the output here?
I have a query here. First, actually, I mean, so
okay,
yeah. My query is like, you have mentioned, see, you have created one constructor, right? In public static void main, you are pass your part. I mean, you are passing one one value, right?
Yes, one parameter.
Yes. And on line 7, in this constructor, you are using this. I mean, using this keyword, you are passing two variables. One yes. Numeric and one is a string, right? So how yes. come this is going to know that what this particular line 8 is going to do? Whether I mean it is not giving any error, seems that means it is understandable that it is checking with the constructor or the line in which this is going to be looking for the two variable constructor. That's it.
Exactly. You see, now it will throw an error. Why? Because yes. your two parameterized constructor was commented, right? So,
yeah, right.
So it cannot call that. This is used to call the current class constructor. So in that way, it was designed. Actually, when you're trying to compile, it is going to check the constructor itself with intent string. So if it cannot find, it will show compile time error. It is same like, for example, you have an M1 method, and if you are trying to call method, and if you delete that M1 method, what happens? It will throw an error, right? The same thing.
Right. So, okay, so you are asking for the sequence, right? So sequence will be like first this will be printing two parameterize, then this will be printing after two per. Okay, it is kind of nested because in two parameterize you have type this, so this is without this should print without any parameter, then two parameters, and then single parameter. It seems, maybe I'm wrong. I'm not sure.
Okay. It's
But
like
they should go
any,
like.
Like you just remember that your execution flow will never change. Like for example, from M1 method you called M2 method, from M2 method you called M3. So what happens? M3 will complete, and after completing your M3 method, where it will come? It will come to the caller method. Who is the caller of M3? M2. And it will complete M2 and it will come to the caller. Who is the caller of M2? M1. So the same way the sequence also. So from main method you start looking what will happen. From main method, which constructor I call? From there, which
yeah,
constructor?
Yeah, it's a single parameter. Yeah.
So then,
so line 7. This was called line 7, and line 7 when it this is going to start line 7. This will on line 8. This is calling the line a constructor with two parameter, which is on line 16. So once line 16 is finished, then this will go back to line 7.
Yes.
I think I need to okay. And once one seven.
What you're telling is right, but I just want I just want
yeah.
what is inside a 0 or inside 2, inside 1. Inside I want that order of output.
Okay. Yeah, it should be inside 2, 1, and 0.
Any other answers?
2, 0, and 1. 2, 0, 1 is maybe like this.
0, 1. Okay.
0, 0, 2, 1.
Yes, exactly. It will be 0, 2, 1. So your explanation is wrong, but why your answer is wrong? Your explanation is right.
Maybe I got a little confused there. Then
whatever, I don't know who said it will be 0, 2, 1.
0, 2. Yeah.
Exactly. Why? Because you call one parameter. It will come to one parameter. But from one parameter, you are not executing this one. This is the first statement. You will call two parameter. Will come to the two parameter. In two parameter also you are not executing that. You are calling zero. It will come to the zero parameter. There is no this keyword here. It will execute your zero. So who is the caller of the zero parameterized constructor? One parameterized constructor. It will come to the one parameterized constructor and it will execute the two parameterized one. And who is the caller of this two parameterized constructor? One parameterized. So it will execute this. And from there it will come to the main method and it will execute. So the output will be 0, 2, 1. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Could someone say the answer? I have not seen it. So you understood when I use this with brackets and this with this keyword. And similarly, you have super and super super bracket and super dot. So it's like we will discuss that in inheritance actually. So once that like a child, and then I'll be discussing it. So we'll go to the package. So what is the meaning of package? And we'll see the access specifier. So here what is a package is whenever you want to represent some group of classes together, you will represent in a thing called package. So package is something, it is combination of some all the classes. Right, so here if you see, I was creating it in a default com.rahul package. In this com.first application, you see you are under my first project. So what happens? Group of classes together will combine as a package. So group of packages together will combine as a project. Group of projects together will combine as an application. Right. So whenever why you need this package concept? Because there will be, when you do a real-time application, there will be some relationship between the classes. So for example, you are trying to do a cargo application, like cargo in the sense like an application where your goods are transferring from one location to another location. Like it's like Flipkart or Amazon, whatever, you know. So whenever you do this ordering, what happens? Whenever you do just an order, like you'll just place an order, but internally to do the order, there are a lot of classes will be there. Like for example, you will be entering all your details, like whatever the shipment that you want, right? So that will have one class, right? And you may, while doing an ordering itself, there may be some validations may happen, right? So you that product cannot be execute like it will be not available, or at the time of ordering itself, it has to fetch some records from a database. So some logic should be there, right? In that case, that cannot be written in one class, right? It will be written, all the ordering things can be written under a group of classes. So then you will keep that as one package, ordering an order as nothing but one package, and you'll keep that and the ordering is one package and all the classes will be under that. So what is that functionality? Would be like interacting with the database for whether the shipment is available when you are trying to buy, or it can be anything like that validation of ordering, whatever it may be. You are getting it, right? So what generally a package is? So package is something, a group of classes. And whenever you want to use a package in some other class, so what you need to do, you need to do import. So if you see, this is my com.first project. This is my one package. So I created it as a project, but this is a package. So because why it is coming under this package? Because I have not like while creating a class, I have not given a package name, and it has taken the project name itself as a package name. So even you can refactor that, like I can rename it. So I can just rename it com dot my first. Otherwise, I can say something like com dot examples one, some package name. So under this com dot examples one, so sorry for that one, I'm not sure why it is coming. You see, under com dot examples one, I am having three classes. So similarly, you can create one more package. So in SRS folder, I'm going to right click on this. New package. So I'm giving a package name called com dot examples two. So this is my second package. So here also I'll be writing a class, something like class. I'm giving a class called name called A. Right? So you have a class A in which package? In com dot examples. And you have some addition class in which package? In com dot examples one package. So for example, I want this object to be created, right? I have a main method. In the main method, what I want to do, I want to call an addition method. I want to call an add method. From generally what we are doing, we are calling an add method from the same class. So even when you want to call it from the same package, what you need to do, you need to create an object. That creation of object I was doing it in the same class, but in an application it will not be doing in the same class, right? You will be doing it in different classes. When it comes to an application, one class object will be created in another class. So that you can say Hagana has a relationship. So I need to create this addition when I want to call an add method out of my class. So I want to call this add method out of my class. So when I want to call this add method out of my class, what I need to do, I need to create this addition object outside my class, because add is a non-static method. So the rule is same. Whenever you want to call a non-static method, the object creation is must. So I need to create the object in a class. So if I am trying to create an object, first what it will say, it is like by default, whenever you trick, the import is happening. So generally that import is mandatory. If you are not trying to import it, it will show me an error. So when you want to use this addition class, which is present in the different package, first thing what you need to do, you need to import this. So in every class you will be declaring. So this is my addition class. At the top of this, you can see, okay, this is under which package, which is stated by package and com.examples1. So this com.examples1 will be the same for constructors and student one, because all these are under this package itself. So this states that com.example2. So it means that my student, everything are under which package? Under com.examples1. So for A, it will be package and the package name. So A is present in this com.examples2. So if you want to use an addition class which is present in the different package, the first thing that I need to do is import. So import that com.addition. So if I do com.examples.addition, what it will do, it is going to import only the addition class. But I want all the classes which are present in my com.examples package to be get imported, then I'll be using a star. So star indicates that all the classes will be imported. So basically it is good practice to use that particular class only. So if you want all the classes, then use the class, a star. If you do not want all the classes, then use just an addition. And what I need to do, I'll be calling that addition. So addition reference variable dot add method. So I'll say why this is not able to call. I'll be telling you this access specifiers, then you get this more clarity. So this is now got, right? I think clear with the packages, and I can execute that add method from here. So run as Java application, which class I am running? I'm running A class, and I'll be getting an output from this addition. So we'll see about access specifiers and our access modifiers. So there's a concept called access specifiers, or I can say access modifiers. So what is this access specifiers or access modifiers? Generally, there are four types: public, default, private, protected. So this public and default is applicable for class level as well as method level. This private and protected is applicable only at a method level. So I cannot apply private and default at class level. We'll see why we cannot apply once we discuss all this, but you can say this cannot apply at class level. So what you mean by cannot applicable at a class level? You cannot use this access specifier before a class. The same thing. You cannot use this protected before a class. So we have a return type, right? So in a class, when you write a method, you will be writing a return type, right? So before the return type, you will be keeping an access specifier. So first we'll see with the public and default, then you get more clarity. So what is public? So This can be applicable at class level and method level. It means I can write an access specifier before a class as well as a before a method. So if I say I have a class A, right? So if I write this before a public, so this is nothing but I am just writing, this is applicable at class level. I am writing an access specifier public before a class. So I can write the same thing before a method also, public void M1. So what is this public? So whenever you write an access specifier public before a class or a before a method, so what it will do is, what it mean, what will happen is nothing but that method or that class can be that can be accessible from outside the class as well as outside the package. So I can access that outside the package if it is public. If it is obviously outside the package, means it can be outside, it is indirectly outside the class also. Whenever you specify an access specifier public to a method or a class, that can be accessible, means I can able to, so the name is indicates, right? What is the meaning of access specifiers or access modifiers? So why you have this concept is, in whenever you do an application for a method or a class, you do not want that prop that thing. For example, in a class, you will have different kinds of methods. So that for one of the method, you want the accessibility more. For one of the method, you do not want the accessibility. For example, simple like curd operation. Whenever you are trying to do curd operations like create, delete, update, right? So which method you want to make it as public? So generally you will make read method as a public, right? So anyone can read it, right? So it means from any other class, they can access the read method, right? But which method you do not want to make it as public, assume that update method or create method. Someone outside the class or some restriction I need to put for some particular method. So then what I'll do, I'll put that as other access specifiers. But we'll see that, but when you do not want that method to have any restrictions, I want that to be used from all over my classes, then I'll put it as public. So simple, like whenever you do an application, you will have some date formatted, right? You will have some utility. What is the meaning of utility? Is whenever you want to convert date to a string or string to a date, you have some format, right? So that same concept, someone has to be used, right? In some other class, that same concept has to be used. Like the conversion of date or conversioning of your float decimal values or some that is a standard functionality of your an application, that when you are trying to convert to a date, it should be always DDMMYY, and version you want that format. So then what you do, you will take one class and you'll write a method, put it that as a public, and that can be accessible from all other classes, right? So in that case, what you put it as public. But you want some other restriction for a method, then you will not put it as a public. We'll see what you will be keeping there. But you are clear with what is access specifiers, right? So what is that use? So as I told you in the beginning, when you learn any concept like the constructors or so, I may tell at the end what is the use of that in a real time scenario. If not, I'll be telling at the end. But if I forgot to, please remind me. So please make sure that whenever you learn any concept, that should have an usage.
Sure. So we are mentioning this public every time, right? But what about default? I never see any class called default or something.
We will see. We have not discussed, right? I just with the public itself, right?
Yeah.
Like when you see the, I'll tell what is default.
Yeah, yeah.
Public, right? If you're not writing anything, that is default. Okay, we'll see.
Okay.
So if I keep it as public, it means can be accessed outside the package. If it is outside the package, obviously it will be outside the class. Package, so it has a higher accessibility. So if you see here, in my addition class. What is this add method? This is a public. So that is the reason you can able to call that method. So you see, this is an addition class. So what is this class? This is a public class. So that is the reason you can able to create an object outside the package. Outside the package means here I can able to do it in my com.examples too. Assume that I'll remove this public access specifier. So if you remove the public access specifier, what it means is nothing but it is default. If you are not writing anything, that is the second level. That is the second one, that is default. You will for a public, you will put it as a public. For default, if you are not writing anything, that is default.
So default is also considered as public, right? You can access like the way we have created a access specifier in the other package and accessing all the methods, right? We have two packages, right? Example one, example two, and in example two we are accessing this addition method, right?
Yes.
So for public, we are able to do it, right? You have shown us that we can do it by importing this package example one, right?
Yes.
com.example one. But now it is default because you remove this public keyword. So
yes.
So let's say in absence of this public keyword, will it be working as the same or behavior is will be changed?
It will not be. So I was telling about the public, right? So public means what it means, it can be accessible outside the package, right? So but in case of default, it is not the case. Default will be only accessible within the package. It means outside the package I cannot access if it is default. Cannot access outside the package if it is default. And if you are not writing anything before a class, it is default. And that cannot be accessed outside the class. So if I have not written addition, I have not written public here. So what it indicates, it is a default. So it cannot be accessed outside the package. So you see, at class A, if I'm trying to create an addition object, it is throwing me an error. See, cannot be accessed two times. So you cannot find that addition. Even the import will also not work. Why? Because I removed the public. So I'll just keep the public, it will be working. That error will go.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
So the same thing applicable for a method also. You see, you can able to, I'll put the class as a public. Right, but I'll remove the method as a pub. I'll remove the method from public. So then can you able to call the method? Obviously no, right? So I removed a public access specifier from a method level. So what it means, it will be a default. If you're not writing anything before a method or before a class, it will be default. So when it case of default, can you able to access add method? No, it will show me the, it cannot be accessible. A method is not visible. So you can create an object of addition class. Why? Because it is public, but you cannot able to access add method because this is not public, it is default. Keep it as public, you can. Clear, right? With public and default. And you have got it for a method level as well as class level. So we'll see the private and protected at method level, and I'll tell you why it is not applicable at a class level. So when it comes to the private, even that cannot be accessible outside the class. So assume that we have an add method, right? So which is of default. So obviously you cannot access from here. But can I able to access that add method from constructor exe? Yes, sure. Why? Because that is not the some other that is the default access specifier. And what I told you, for a default, only accessible within the package. So it means constructor is in the constructor and addition are both are in the same package. So it means if my add method is of default, I should be able to accessing it that in constructor example. Am I right?
And you can call the constructor in this example too in other package, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So what I'll do, I want to call an add method. So this is a constructor exe. From the both are in constructor exe and addition are in same package. Now I want to call an add method that is present in the addition class of default, which having the default access specifier. So which is of non-static. What I'll do, I'll create an object that I can do. Anyway, so then what I'll do, I'll call ad.add. So you can able to access it, right? It is not throwing an error, but it cannot be accessible outside the package when it is default. But when it is default, within the package can be accessible. Is it clear, right? But when it is private, whenever you keep it as a private, for a private, it is within the class. With in the class. It means I cannot access outside the class. I cannot call that add method from constructor the example, because that is outside my class if that access specifier is of private. So I'll try to keep this as a private, then what should happen? This should throw me an error. See, it is throwing me an error. It cannot able to call the add method. Why? It is private. Private means within the class itself. I'll remove this. Your error will go. Private. So I cannot call even within the package. I should be calling this add method from the same class itself. So I should not be. So whenever you want some methods, you have that kind of scenarios, right? That you want some create operation code or something that you are trying to do, and you want that method not to be accessible outside the class, then you put that as a private. You want some of the method that cannot be accessible, you want that accessibility, like remove some restriction, like you want that to only within the package. So for example, as I told you in the beginning, for ordering, you want only that order classes, related classes should access that, right? Then you keep that as a default. You want some utility, you want some method that is a utility for all the packages, right? Then what you do, you keep that as a public. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So before going to protected, we should be having an idea on inheritance. So anyone have an idea what is inheritance? Like heard about that? Like as I told you, there are OOPs concepts, and we have discussed about encapsulation. Encapsulation is something, as I told you, and binding everything together. The class is an example of encapsulation. And similarly, we have a concept called inheritance in Java. So what is this inheritance? Whenever this is nothing but parent and child relationship. Assume that I have a class A, or I can say some class called manager. So I am having a class called employee. Otherwise, shall I take it as okay, whatever it may be. So what I want, there are some actions that manager will be doing it, right? So what I want, all the actions which is performed by a manager, the employee also should do, right? So for example, manager will also do timesheet login. I think you can able to relate this, right? I think most of you are experienced. So like an organization as well as I'm talking it. So like he's going to do that when like the daily, is it fine to take this example or something else?
Yeah, this one is good. I mean, timesheet we are doing, we all are doing, right? Whoever is working, we are doing the timesheets. Yeah.
So I think most of you are working somewhere or some experience only, right? So I think you can able to relate this very easily. So some kind of timesheet, like every day that you do the timesheet, right? So this is the functionality, and this is one of the action that a manager do, right? And what a manager does is nothing but still. Okay, let me take some other examples like the timesheet or some work he does. So say so whatever the function that this timesheet and some other x or y works, x, y, z, some functionalities. So all these functionalities, assume that even an employee has to do, right? Apart from that, employee may do some other works also, but whatever the common works, right, what manager is doing, that even the employee must do, right? In that case, what I can make, it's not required me to write all this functionality again in the employee, right? So what I can do, whenever you do an applications also, there is a chance that you can establishing manager employee relation is not at all good, but I'm just trying to tell. So then what happens, then you can able to make a child and parent relationship. Why I made a child and parentship relationship concept, you have some functionalities that is common between the two classes, right? Then what you can do, you can write, you can make the second class of the class as a child. What I'm doing, I'm making my employee class as nothing but the child of manager class. So whatever the functionalities which is done by manager will automatically comes to an employee. It is not required you to write the same logic and same code. So by default, it is inherited. All the parent properties will be inherited to the child. So if you want some functionalities, like class A has the 10 functionalities, that same 10 functionalities was required for other class. So then what you do, you just make that as a child and parent relationship. They will have a child and parent relationship. And when you do a child and parent relationship, this is the extends is the keyword that you use. Extends manager, class employee, extends manager. So your manager is a parent and your employee is nothing but a child. So apart from that, he may do some other work like coding or some other functionality apart from your manager and employee tools. And he will be doing all the works that manager also does. Some of the works, like you will not do all the work generally, but I'm just taking in this example. What all the works manager is doing, that employee is also doing. Apart from that, he is taking some more additional work also. So there will be some child and parent relationship. So establishing between manager and as I'm telling you, it's not good, but I've just taken it. So I'll try to come up with good some more good examples for inheritance. But as of now, you can understand the concept of inheritance. The inheritance is nothing but getting the properties from parent to a child, and the child will have some extra properties, and the parent will not get the child properties, but the child will get the parent properties. It is like as we are parent and child. So how I do that parent, how I'll establish the parent and child. So you call this as a user relationship. So how I'll establish the parent and child relationship by using a keyword called extends. So what I'll write, we'll see there are types of inheritance and we'll see more on that. But as of now, you can understand. So extends the keyword, which will make the child and parent relationship. So extends manager means your manager is the parent of your employee. And your employee will get all the properties of your manager. So here we are discussing about an access specifier, and we are just left with the protected, right? I think you are a little clear on inheritance. So why I told that inheritance here is nothing but to understand the protected, you need to have the little knowledge on inheritance. So whenever, as you know, with the default, you cannot accessible outside the package, right? And even you cannot be able to access whenever it's private, you cannot able to access within the class also, without within the package also. So that can be indirectly accessible when there is a child and parent relationship. So what is the meaning of child and parent relationship? For example, I have an addition class. So in this addition, this add is what? This is nothing but my default method. So whether can able to access this? For sure, I cannot able to access it from my A class. Why? Because this is outside the package. So whenever it is default. So assume that I'll make it as protected. So when you make it as protected, you can able to access that, but in indirectly. So what is an indirectly? So I have a class A, right? In this class A, so for sure you cannot able to access that directly, but you can access it in indirectly. So what is the meaning of indirect? Means I am making this class A as a child of my addition. So extends addition. Now who is my parent? Addition is the parent. And what is this A? This is nothing but A is nothing but the child. So I will have some method, something like void m1 method. So what is this method? This method is in which class? Of A class. Then what I'll do, I'll be creating A class object. A equals to reference equals to new A. And what I'll do, I'll be calling A dot m1 method. So I'm calling the same class M1. So from this M1 method, what I can do, I can call a parent class method. So to call the parent class method, I told you, I have told you this and this with brackets, and I told I need to tell super and super with brackets. So now here I'll be telling you super keyword. So what is the meaning of this indicate? This is used to call the current object constructors, or this for a current class. Now you have a keyword called super in Java. What it is used to do is nothing but it is used to call the parent class methods. So what is the parent of my A class? Addition class. So if I want to call a parent class method that add which is present in my parent class, from my child class, then I'll be using a keyword called super. So I can use super dot m1, not m1, super dot add. M1 is here. So this is how I can able to call this addition from the class A. So I'm executing this and you're getting an output. Whenever it is a protected. So there is in the, whenever you can call the child, whenever you, if the access specifier is a protected for a method level, so you can able to call that indirect way. What is the meaning of indirect way? Whenever there is a child and parent relationship. So assume that if it is not protected, if it is default, can I call that in that way? Can someone tell? You understood with the protected, I can call it whenever there is a child and parent relationship. The same thing can I do whenever it is default? For sure, if there is no child and parent relationship, you cannot do that. We have seen it. But if there is a child and parent relationship, like how I'm calling this super dot add method. So which is going to call super means parent class. Add method. Who is my parent class for A? Add is a parent class. Sorry, addition is a parent class of A. So in that parent class, we are calling an add method. So in this case, if it is not protected, if it is default, can I do the same?
Yes, we can.
No, you can.
Okay.
You cannot do. Why? Because that is a it is not that is the concept of your default. Default will never allow outside the package, whether it is a child, parent, whatever the relationship it is. If it is default, that cannot be accessible outside the package. So that rule will never be overridden. That is same for all the cases. So it means whenever it is default, you cannot able to call that outside the package. So now if I remove the protected, that will show me an error. So why? Even that indirect way also cannot be accessible, that add method. So whenever it is default, it is not at all visible outside the package. So whenever it is not visible outside the package, but it's like you cannot call it in direct way or indirect way. But in protected, you can do it. That indirect way. Even protected cannot be done directly. If it is protected, even if there is no child and parent relationship, I cannot call that we have seen. Is it clear about
Yes.
public, private, protected and default? So as I told you, I'll tell you why you cannot apply this private and protected at a class level. So why? Because the main concept of Java to write a class is nothing but that class has to be used somewhere, right? So when you do an application, you are writing an addition class. So obviously this addition class will be called from outside the package or outside the class itself. Right, for sure it will be done, because when you create a controller layer, when you create a service layer, if you see that MVC architecture, that could be more little, but when you write a class, the main purpose of class is to be that class will be called from outside, right? So that is the concept of a class. And if you are violating that by making an access specifier called private or protected, that is concreting, right? So what is the concept of private? That will not be allowed outside. So, but what is the concept of class? The class, we will be writing a class generally that will be used for from outside the package or outside the class itself. Like when you want to call, when you want this class to be used for, obviously this should be called from outside only. So without calling from outside, how it will be used? So, but when you keep it as private, what private is telling, that cannot be gone outside. So that is concreting, right? So that is the reason they are not allowed to keep an access specifier called private or protected at a class level. So if you are trying to keep, and it will state me an illegal access specifier. If you're trying to write it as private or protected, only public and default are allowed. The same. It is an illegal access specifier. Okay, so it's like I'm giving some more assignment, so please try to do, like try to write whatever I have done it. So try to create a same package, different package. I have written only every, I've shown an example only with an add method, right? But I want, please try to do it in, with all the methods, right? So write one public method, write one default, protected, private. Write all the methods and write, try to write the two packages and try to call all the things. So it's like what I am doing is nothing but what I told you, that's it. But I have just shown you everything with an add method, but try to create different methods, right? So take it the real time scenarios, or it may be anything, right? So, but take all the scenarios, try to create two packages and use all the access specifiers for one of the method, like private, protected, default, all the access specifiers, and try to call that all the methods. If it is private, within the, you will be calling within the class. If it is default, within the package. Protected, make child and parent relationship and call. For public, you can call from anywhere. So for public, try to call it from other packet. That's it. Is it clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Any queries for others, even? Okay. If no, I'll wind up the session. Okay. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thanks for the session.
Thank you.